What's up, everyone? It's your boy X-Men87 here, bringing you another Marvel Legends review video. And this time, what I have for you today is the X-Men Legends Caliban BAF series Beast action figure review. Before I get into everything, if you could please leave a like rating on the video, that'll show your support for my channel. I truly appreciate it. And with that said, oh my god, this is the Beast we've been waiting for. I am so happy. He's on a handstand. Because you've seen everyone, and I've seen everyone, take pics of him doing a handstand. Because, well, it's just freaking awesome, okay? You have to do it. And cut, Sina. yeah, he is so freaking awesome. I love the handstand type of pose. And you know what, guys? There is a lot going on with this figure that I have to let you know right now. That I will let you know, obviously, because that's why I'm reviewing it, right? He's just so freaking cool. And you're probably going to hear me say that a lot, and I'm probably going to annoy the crap out of you. But I'm sorry. He just is. And so, definitely want to go over this guy because there's just so much to cover. Let's start off with his head sculpt. I mean, just he's an all new sculpt. This is a dream figure for me. I'm just like geeking out. Oh man, look at this. He's just gorgeous. Oh man, I love the face, and this is Jim Lee accurate. You know, with the white pupils, and I know everyone is probably wishing for a normal, you know, Beast head where he shows his kind of like, you know, intellect, like reading a book, just that nice calm Beast. Trust me, I do as well, and I feel like they'll give us that down the line. But for now, man, I'm taking this, and this is just a major upgrade over the Toy Biz one for sure. And while I probably might like that head sculpt better on the Toy Biz, overall, I love this Hasbro one better. I don't have the Toy Biz one to compare side by side. As I don't think a lot of you know, but you know, when I got hit with a stomach disease, I had to sell a lot of my collection, and those were ones to go. And yeah, sad time in my life. But for real, this Beast figure is... it's beautiful. I love the head sculpt. I love everything about it. I loved every hair sculpt on this freaking figure. Ah, it's just so awesome. Ah, I love it. So, I will say there's a lot going on with articulation. As you can already see, he's got butterfly joints. He's got a double ab crunch. He's got, you know, the torso articulation. He's got everything that you would want in a Beast figure. And so, you know, taking a closer look at his head sculpt. And let me just get the light here. And by the way, I have the Danger Room in the background. Let me know if you want me to review my X-Men figures using the Danger Room. But wow, this guy, the blue is perfect too. I love the blue on this. And maybe some of my lights are, you know, a bit harsh. It's kind of hot. Still, it's a beautiful blue color. And it's definitely a better upgrade than the Toy Biz one because of the double ab crunch. You could not get the ab crunch on that Beast figure. It was just sculpted. And he was just like crouched over the whole time. Come on, man. Beast has got to make backflips. And that right there, Hasbro already beat Toy Biz right there with that. You got to capture everything about the character as far as, you know, mobility wise. When it's those type of agile characters, they have to have a lot of articulation going on. And, you know, Hasbro definitely wins in that category. Definitely love this one over the Toy Biz way more. Again, I still love that head sculpt, but oh man, I could definitely see a Dark Beast down the line with this, which could be a good place to put an alternate head for this beast as well. Man, he's just so freaking cool. So, accessory-wise, as you see, he's got two hands, and they're pretty much like these grabbing hands. He's got the one handstand here, and you can balance him to do the handstand, and a fisted hand. Kind of wish he had two of these and two fisted ones. That would have been cool. But just to swap out the other one. So with this, I'll show you guys these hands. He's got the holding hands, which is pretty good for, like, if you want to do a picture of him swinging on something, you know, like a pole or something. That's when it's best used for. And since I have my Danger Room diorama, let's put that to the test, shall we? So I will have my beast, you know, kind of like in a swinging pose of sort, just to show you how this guy, you know, poses with these hands. So I definitely took a lot of pics with this guy. So start over here. I'm just gonna reach over and just making sure right there. Whoops, my other piece is falling out. Oop, there we go. And now, as you can see, that's pretty much to have, you know, beast hanging, doing some, you know, crazy leaps and Olympic type acrobatic poses. So had no problem hanging them there. So that's pretty cool. Same goes as for the other hand. Well, it's a little, this one's a little tricky, but could kind of make that work. It's just that pinky and the thumb kind of closes together where they meet. Well, this one's probably good to do something like this. I guess he could do like a handstand there. You know, something like that. I'm not gonna try risk breaking my Danger Room bridge right there, but just want to give you the guys a heads up of how, you know, you can utilize him in various poses. So would have been cool if he had like a Danger Room accessory where he could swing around and things like that. That'd be really cool. And to go over articulation with this guy, his head moves that far up. His head moves this far down, left and right. And he's got some good head pivot right there. So that's really, really cool. His arms move that far up. So, you know, the sculpt right here with the fur is definitely going to hinder how high the shoulder moves. But because of the beautiful butterfly joints, look at that. That has so much range. That's amazing. You can kind of move it like so to try to get his arm up like that. So you're just going to have to, you know, finagle with it. But his arms move all around, as you just saw. He's got the bicep swivel, double jointed elbows. Beautiful. He's got the wrist hinge up and down, and wrist swivel side to side. He's got a beautiful ab crunch, a double ab crunch. So you got the torso swivel right here, and you got the lower ab crunch that you've seen on the 12-inch Marvel Legends figures. So he moves that far down and that far back. So you could do your, you could capture your beast backflips like so. And he's got the torso rocker, torso swivel, however you want to, you know, utilize that. And when it comes to the legs, now, this is very important. Please, please, please pay very close attention to what I'm going to do here. His legs move that far up, right? But if you want them to go any higher or make them range, it kind of works like an import. So what you're going to do is grab his thighs and pull them down, and you should hear a click. You see that? I'm going to do that again. So now you can extend the legs. So you're going to hear that click. And I'm going to pull it down. So you can definitely get him to range farther with his legs. And it'll move that much higher. So that is freaking awesome. And moves that far out. You got the thigh swivel. You got the double jointed knees and heel to the butt. And you can even move, shift this leg up and down, up and down. You could, you know, again, however you want, whatever, you know, the amount of range you want in your beast figure, which you're gonna want the most range. But it's just amazing. And you got the ankles that move up, down, you got the ankle pivot, and you got the toe articulation, which is freaking cool. This figure needs it. I'm not big on toe articulation a lot of times, only on certain figures, and definitely with this figure, it's necessary. Definitely with Beast, it's necessary. But just checking out, the only gripe I have with this figure as far as paint apps is the X, just like my Forge figure, the paint bleed, the X is not fully colored in black. It's not fully painted in black, so that's a bummer. But all around, man, his sculpt is beautiful. Look at that. Look at the hair sculpt on the legs, the calves there, even to his beastly toes. Holy crap, this is beautiful. I'm already calling it. This is gonna be my favorite Marvel Legends figure of the year. The only thing I see beating this for me would be the 80-year anniversary Classic Hulk in the 2-pack with Wolverine. I think it's gonna come down to those two as my favorite Marvel Legends of 2019. But this Beast figure, it's everything I wanted and more. So. Not everything I wanted. You know, I wanted that, like, an alternate head that definitely, you know, would have been the icing on the cake for me. But still, guys, this is an amazing figure. I highly recommend it. Definitely an 11 out of 10 for me. It's total awesomeness. And, just to put him next to, one of his wave mates, Gambit, since we're rounding out the X-Men Blue team. So you can see how he looks next to, the Raging Cajun. And let's just put Forge there for the hell of it. I know he's, you know, can't wait to review this whole wave, and definitely gonna cover X-Men Blue as well. And all right, guys, leave a like rating on the video, comment, we'll chat about it. Let me know what your thoughts of Beast and how he articulates. And I hope you found it informative, especially when covering the leg articulation, which is, it's imperative to let you guys know that. It was imperative to let you guys know that. You gotta know how to, you know, handle these figures and handle how much they range. All right, guys, share and subscribe, leave a notification bell. Hit the notification bell so you guys know that, you know, my reviews are up. And with that said, I'll see you on the next review. Peace.